Okay, thank you to having me at this ChessCon conference call. I want to present the detailed simulation what ChessCon did at the Red Sea Gateway terminal. As an introduction, not to introduce myself completely, but you will hear, let's say, my name is Siti Nedelhof, and you will hear in my accent that I'm coming from the Netherlands, so that's good. From a career perspective, I started from automated terminals, so that is Hutchinson, ECT in Rotterdam. I've done also the neighbor terminal from APMT, that is Rotterdam World Gateway, so the APMT Maasvlakte 2. Also worked at Port Base and in Qatar at Hamad Port, and now in Jeddah. Reason that I'm saying that is more that I'm now in the business more than 20 years. On simulation perspective, I'm a strong believer in simulations. It's already expressed by a lot of colleagues during the presentation. For simulations, we did it in Rotterdam World Gateway. That is the fully automated terminal down there. It's a greenfield terminal. We've done simulations for the designing of the terminal, and also for testing with emulators, but we also use it contractually. Another terminal was also the Hamad Port in Qatar, was also a greenfield terminal, and was also designing for terminal layouts and gates. Currently, I'm now at Saudi Arabia. It's a brownfield terminal, and it's used for the designing, and also for comparison for the YAR strategy. The background is more from at the Red Sea. We want to move forward with automation, and because of the automation, Royal Harsh Koning and Sedeco created a master plan for automation. For the master plan, it was simulated by Aquanet Sescom. However, also during the recent expansion of Red Sea, we also want to verify the impact of changing the current yard strategy with a detailed simulation strategy. The main reason is that because of, hopefully you're seeing my mouse, so at the left corner, so original, our terminal was, let's say, this size. And because of the expansion, we expanded with at least the same size. Because of the expansion, we also need to change the yard strategy or not. And also you can resolve a lot of it with prime route and expert decking. But still, we were also looking at if we want to change the complete yard strategy to really combine the two terminals in also in the amount of TTs and in the amount of RTGs. And for that, we requested ChessCon to verify what is the impact if we're changing the yard strategy. And the impact must be then on equipment, on also for us, it's more the business case related to the amount of staff, what will be the impact on that one also, and looking forward. The challenge is also for this one, and that is, I'm a strong believer, what I've mentioned previously, I'm a strong believer of simulation. However, a lot of people are also skeptical. And therefore, the approach was a little bit different, because with the simulation, with the greenfield, you're going for the highest performance in the lab environment. However, for a brownfield, for a simulation, for a business strategy, we want to have, let's say, the as-is situation as close as possible to reality. Because it doesn't make sense to make a business case and the figures are not realistic in comparison with the current situation. Therefore, we approach with ChessCon. And it was also a little bit demonstrated by ChessCon itself in the previous presentation. We asked them as an approach to run a simulation for the as-is situation, and on the existing yard strategy, also the existing layout. Then the second step was to verify the simulation with the historical operational data. And so that is really the as-is. And the third step was B. Okay, do the simulation with the data what you're having on equipment, on the layout, on each step. Do the simulation with the new yard strategy. And then the last step was then undertake the comparison between both strategies. So for the as-is situation, we just put everything in it. The right drawing, the technical drawing, that's coming from Chesscon itself. I didn't invent it. But what we just did is we selected as RGT a timestamp, a time frame of 1 week. We selected the boxes, the vessel, what will happen. Then we shared all the data what we're having from and foresight. Also the birds planning and all the data from everything what we could find, what will help the simulation. The idea was then to compare as is with the realistic, let's say, the reports what we're having, with what we can compare. Because let's be fair, we're also skeptical about simulations. Yeah, because you also need to convince everyone that you've done the right simulation. And by comparing what is the outcome of the simulation, comparing with the real data what you're having, we having differences and we want to reduce the amount of differences. At least we know the bandwidth difference between as is and how they're simulating. Later on, when we do the 2B situation with the yard strategy differences, then we also calculating partially the differences what we discovered during the as-is simulation. So at the end, we compared the as-is to 2B. And the as-is to 2B was more related to, okay, we did want to know the business case. What Chesscon provided was a detailed report with all the ins and outs. But this is just a summary what we've done. We just compared the amount of deployed units, what we're having with TTs, and also the running hours of it. And then also with the RTGs. And also we could compare it with the amount of shifts on staff members. And then compare it with what are the differences between one yard strategy and the other yard strategy. So as a conclusion, so it was helpful internally, especially for the members who don't believe in simulations. Simulations is more for greenfield and less for brownfields. Main issues what we're having was also, let's say, COVID. Reason that I'm saying that is more during the comparison from the as-is situation. At a certain moment, Chesscon was presenting and figures what it was too good to do, too good, and we couldn't compare it with the as-is situation what we are facing. And main reason was that there was one step forgotten in the inspection. And normally wise, if you're going physically down here, then it is much easier to witness which steps do we need to implement. Another issue was also we had some Nevis with move-ins issues, so we need to correct certain steps. But that was also being worked out. main conclusion at our side. Did it work? Yes. I think we did convinced. However, you were always having some difficulties. And was it also useful? Yes, it was also useful because it's also, let's say, for the next step in automation, if you have the right base set, but also what APT is saying, then for further steps in automation, in lab testing and also in other testing for upgrades, then it becomes useful. So I think I've never done it like this, because I'm always doing, let's say, greenfields, but for the brownfield, for your strategy, also what was being done in Africa, it becomes a good, useful step. And that's it.